Okay, this is going to be the third video about square roots and radicals. And in this one, I'm going to deal with square roots and higher roots, like third roots and fourth roots, of variables. And the nice thing is, this stuff is really easy. So let's look at an example. So let's say I've got the square root of x squared. So what this is asking me to do is find the number, the variable, that I can square to get x squared. This is not a trick question. It's really as easy as it sounds. So the number that the variable that I square to get x squared would be x. So the square root of x squared is just x, because x squared is x squared. Here's another one. I need to find the third root of a to the third. So I'm looking for the variable that I can raise to the third power to get a to the third. And once again, there's really no difficulty to it. It's just going to be a. If this index and this exponent are the same, basically all you're going to have when you solve the square root, or solve the radical, is going to be whatever the variable is here. Here's another one. So this is the ninth root of x to the ninth. Well, that's just going to be x. Okay? So let's look at some more. A little bit more difficult, but really nothing to worry about. So here I've got the third root of x to the sixth. That means I'm looking for a number, a variable, that I can raise to the third power and get x to the sixth. So let's think about this. I know that I'm going to have something with an x, and I want to raise it to the third power to get x to the sixth. Well, remembering my rules for exponents, there was this rule that says that if I have a variable or a number raised to a power, and it's raised to a higher power, I multiply the exponent over here, inside the parentheses, you could say, and the exponent outside the parentheses. So what could I put in this box here to multiply by 3 and get a 6? Well, the answer is going to be a 2. So this is x squared, because x squared to the third power is x to the sixth. Now, a nice way to do this is, if you think about it, since multiplication and division are opposites, instead of setting the problem up like this, I can just think, if I divide the 3 into the 6, in other words, if I divide the index into the exponent under the radical sign, I'm going to get the exponent of my answer. So 3 divided into 6 is 2. Let's try that with another one. Here I've got the fifth root of a to the 15th. So using that method, I should be able to divide 5 into 15. 5 into 15 goes 3 times, and that's going to give me a to the third. Well, let's check that. So a to the third raised to the fifth power, 3 times 5 is 15. That gives me a to the 15th, and that's my radicand. Okay, one more. So here I have the square root of y to the 8th. Now, something I haven't mentioned before, but when you have a square root, there's no index, but the index is understood as being a 2. Okay, you don't have to write it, but it's understood as being there. You can write it if you want. So to solve this, I'm going to divide the index into the exponent that I have under the radical sign. So I'm dividing 2 into 8. 8 divided by 2 is 4. So the answer to this would be y to the fourth. And I can check it. Y to the fourth raised to the second power, 4 times 2 is 8, is going to give me y to the eighth. Okay? So basically all you're doing is dividing the index into this exponent and that's going to give you what you have in your simplified answer. Okay? When we did the other ones, just to go back to them for a second, you could think of yourself as doing the same thing. 2 divided into 2 is 1. This is x to the first. 3 divided into 3 is 1. This is a to the first. 9 divided into 9 is 1. And this is x to the first. Okay, now, one more point I want to make, which you may be covering in class or you may not, and your teacher may care about it or may not care about it. So let's go back to this simple one, the square root of x squared. And we said the square root of x squared was x. Let me clarify this a little bit. Let's say that x equals 3. And let's work through this problem. Okay, so that would mean that the square root of x squared would be the same as the square root of 3 squared. And the 3 squared is 9, and the square root of 9 is 3, and 3 equals x. So that's fine. Now, let's say that x equals negative 3, and let's try that same process. So I've got the square root of x squared, and that's going to equal the square root of negative 3 squared. And the square root of negative 3 squared is the square root of 9. And the square root of 9, because remember, I can only have positive square roots. The square root of 9 is going to be 3. And 3 does not equal x, because it does not equal negative 3. So technically, when we want to solve a problem like the square root of x squared, what we're going to write is that the square root of x squared equals the absolute value of x. These two bars here around a number or a variable mean absolute value, which is another way of saying the positive value. So the absolute value of negative 3 is just a positive 3. If x equals negative 3, the absolute value of this x is the same as the absolute value of negative 3, which is 3. So if your teacher is covering this in class, and if it's an important point on the test, when you're given a problem where you have to find the square root of a variable, and that variable is squared, write your answer in absolute value signs. If your teacher says that it doesn't matter, that they're not going to cover that, then don't worry about it. Okay? So check with your teacher and see if that's important. Other than that, this stuff, like I said, is really simple. All you're doing, let me just take a page here and review it. All you're doing is taking the index, dividing it into the exponent, and that's going to tell you the power that your variable is raised to when you take it outside of the radical sign. Okay? And that's all there is to it. Take care. See you next time.